And I really admire the fact that so many Latin musicians, they protect their culture. If you're gonna play this music, you better play it the right way. Just don't bring your stuff in and say, okay, well, I'm playing your stuff my way. You're gonna learn the traditional rules first. Then you have to earn the right to be able to bring your thing in there. Introduction into what is known as Latin jazz was as a kid because my father played bass with Mongo Santamaría. My dad played with Mongo from 77 to 81. So along with hearing the Temptations, James Brown, Beethoven, my grandfather's classical albums, my great uncle's jazz albums, I was hearing Mongo. I saw my father play with Mongo many, many times as a kid. That feeling of Cuba and that fusion of Cuban, American, and there was some guys in the band from Puerto Rico, and just kind of hearing that whole gumbo, which jazz itself is, you know, that struck me deeply. And then once I really started to kind of try my best to sort of get underneath and figure out what that music was about, I found out like all of this history, all of the subtext. So I started learning, you know, about all these, you know, Montunos and the cha-cha-cha, and I learned about Cachao, the legendary Israel Lopez. I became a student of this music. And the first time I played with the great Eddie Palmieri, it made me really nervous. I had no minor league training. I never got a chance to play any Latin gigs in New York with people who weren't quite as big legends as Eddie Palmieri. So here I go into the recording studio, no less. It wasn't even a gig where we could kind of work stuff out. It was a recording session. I was scared to death. You know, I go over to the piano, I'm like, you know, Mr. Palmieri, you know, what should I play on this groove here? And, you know, he kind of played it out for me. You know, he was very, very nice about it. And then after we played a couple of tracks, he gave me two great compliments. He came up to me and he said, you sure you're not from the Bronx? I said, wow, okay, I knew that's a compliment. And then after we played a couple of other tracks, and actually after the session was over, he said, come here. And he put his hand on my forehead. He said, I now bless you as an honorary Latin soul brother.